I'm here.
Replaced your sister with a cat.
Nice. I think you'll get more views.
Not even
more views with a cat.
No. Well, she's hard to get rid of.
Are we recording?
Yeah.
We're recording. Well, yeah, man.
We didn't even do a 3-2-1. All right.
3-2-1.
All right. Is here this we go. Yeah, Chivas Regal, 12-year. This is blended Scotch whiskey started by the Chavez brothers in 1850. They were grocers, actually. They owned a grocery store, but they decided to blend whiskey in order to sell to the customers. And then over the years, that's what it became Chavez 12. But it was originally called Royal Glendine. Royal Glendine.
And does 12 mean that it was made by 12-year-olds? Is that what we're drinking here?
I think that's exactly right.
There's a lot of white.
I knew it.
Exactly. We support child labor.
Yeah, I knew it.
Okay. I'll do a cork popping on this, but
let's do it anyway.
It's a screw off.
We're gonna do
screw. All right, let's screw up. We're gonna screw off together.
Mine is halfway done. What are you talking about?
All right. Well, on the count of three. Okay, 1, 2, and screw off.
Yeah.
Cheers to screwing off, man.
Cheers. All right.
So the 12 actually is an age statement. It means it's a 12-year-old blended whiskey, which means the oldest barrel of whiskey that's blended together is 12 years. It could also mean that there's a 1 to 2 to 3, whatever it is, blended in there, but the oldest barrel is 12. And they will all come from different warehouses. So you will have several, I just assume, Speyside whiskeys blended to make this whiskey. And they're going to sit for at least 6 months blended together before bottled. Yeah, it should actually be somewhat similar. Cheers.
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 Ding.
So give it a smell, first of all. Are there any flavor notes that you are smelling just off the top of your head? Do you smell anything reminiscent to, like, maybe a fruit?
A honey?
A vanilla, something along those lines.
Alcohol. My nose hairs are burning.
So if that's the case, then you just pull it back a bit until you no longer feel the burning sensation, and then give it a good breath. It helps a little bit, though, if you have your mouth slightly open when you do that, because it allows you to pull in a little bit more of the essence.
Well, with my mouth open, I smell calatosis.
Is that okay? I smell your sister.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Corey. Oh, my lighting.
Oh, see, there you go. That is what happens when both of you make fun of me.
So I can get a little bit. Let's just see if you can pull these out if I name them. How about honey?
Nah, it's very spicy.
How about a little bit of nutty essence?
I smell the nutty. I smell the honey.
Okay. Vanilla? Get a little bit of vanilla out of there?
Yeah.
I'd rather just smell the alcohol.
Smell the alcohol. Maybe after 2008.
Right. A little bit of graham. Like just a little bit of like a graham cracker kind of biscuity graham.
Yeah.
Just
okay, now what?
All right, so now we're going to go ahead and take a sip, and we're going to try to get past the fact that this is a 40% whiskey, and it's going to have a little bit of a burn in an ethanol, but we're going to try to pull a little bit of flavor out of there. Just anything that it might remind you of, like dark fruit, once again, vanilla, honey, any of those things. All right, cheers. Let's give it a little sip.
Cheers.
Well, that right there, that'll make you draw a horse with a wagon. You know what I'm saying? That'll put a cover over the wagon, too.
It's really smooth. But it's
I have no idea what you're saying.
It's very sweet.
Yeah.
Very, very sweet. Yeah. I go back to honey, but also I get a little bit of, like, a little bit of dark fruit, some citrus. Like,
I just find it spicy.
Yeah. Yeah. It's kind of for 40%, it actually has a bit of a burn, doesn't it?
Yeah, spicy as in burning back your throat.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's not normal?
Well, I mean, it depends on the whiskey. Like, sometimes you'll get something that's a higher ABV that is a little bit smoother than this even, and it won't even burn that much. But the burning's
normal though.
Yeah, but this is staying warm for a while.
Yeah, that's the alcohol.
That's your finish. It's kind of a medium finish, where it kind of warms you on the way down, right? Mm-hmm. That will dissipate, especially as you drink this more. You're going to notice that less, and the flavors in the whiskey a little bit more.
That's why people like it in the wintertime.
Do you get a little bit of red licorice?
No, Corey.
What do you get?
Just burning alcohol.
I mean, I guess there's no wrong way to taste it.
my palate is not as sophisticated as yours. How do you rank this one with the other ones that you have?
For a malted or a blended whiskey that's affordable, I wouldn't say this is like bottom shelf, but it's just an affordable scotch.
But it's definitely not top shelf.
No, not this. This has everything you expect out of like a Speyside scotch, where it's probably aged in sherry casks. So it's sweet. It's not going to be peaty. It's not going to be smoky. But it's also not going to give you any surprises.
Yeah, this is like an everyday scotch.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it.
Like at lunchtime, like right about noon.
Yeah, first thing in the morning. Honestly. Yeah. It's just
with Cheerios. This is a Cheerio scotch.
This is when you're going to wake up and go back to bed.
Yeah. This is, I have my finance meeting at 9 a.m., Cheerios and scotch.
What are your final thoughts?
What are your final thoughts on this? How did you enjoy it?
My final thoughts is there's no more left.
Yeah.
So that's a win.
Cool. It's nice and it's a neutral. It's, it's in the middle of the road. It's not offensive. So it's a nice entry and yeah, it's a good drink.
The people that are going to watch this are going to want to know, if there's anything you want people to know about you, now is the time. And it could be anything, because this doesn't get edited. Anything you want anyone to know.
I want everybody to know is, like, let's go Raptors. That's what I want everyone to know.
All right.
Back-to-back. With an asterisk on 2020. But, thing ever. Well, I need the green screen. Okay, let's go Raptors, and Star Wars is the best. That's where I'm going to go.
You don't want to tell anyone you made some, like, genius kids or anything?
Oh no, I'm still waiting for the results on that.
See, that's a thing, right?
Yeah. I will say that. If you're going to have kids, have more than one. Because if one's a screw-up, you have extras. Okay, so what's the sign-off? What's the sign-off on this thing? Do you have a sign-off?
No. I usually just say cheers and, like, you know, keep drinking. Don't fall off a balcony when you do drink. And, you know, if that oil starts to look delicious, maybe go this route instead.
Because I do like the sign-ups, what did you call it, twist-off?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So, that's brilliant. So, it's about time we twist the hell off.
Yeah, so, like, do we twist on? But, like, I got no more.
You gotta twist on before you twist off, that's the problem.
Yeah, but we twisted off in the beginning. But
now
not
twist off.
Okay, so,
okay.
All right, here we go.
Sorry, yeah.
We're about to twist off air by twisting on, all right?
Yeah,
and twist off. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thanks for revealing, man.
Bye. Can't wait.